Only one chapter I have covered. So those students are present today or not? বুঝতেই পারছি না, তারা কি আছো?
ইয়েস ম্যাম, ম্যাম
হ্যাঁ
সি
ম্যাম,
প্রোগ্রামিং এর স্টার্টিং এ মানে ইন্ট্রোডাকশনটা কিছুটা হয়েছিল।
তারপরে কি তোমরা আর কোনো ক্লাস পেয়েছিলে এমসিএ
না 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 না
বিসিএ থেকে? কতজন আছো আমাকে একটু রেজ হ্যান্ড করো তো, হাউ মেনি আর ফ্রম বিসিএ? মোটামুটি যা দেখা যাচ্ছে, টেন টু 11 পার্সনস আর ফ্রম বিসিএ। সো তোমাদের কি কিছু প্রায়ার নলেজ আছে, মানে পার্টিকুলার কোনো চ্যাপ্টার কি চাইছো যেটা আমি বোঝাই, না প্রথম থেকেই চাইছো?
ম্যাম প্রথম থেকে, ম্যাম প্রথম দিকেই স্টার্ট করি।
Then MC student, you just follow the classes because already I have covered the things. Acha, for C, the character sets which are being supported, they are basic C character set, that is alphabets from A to Z in capital and small are supported, numbers from 0 to 9 are supported, and some special characters which are given here, they are being supported. Now, what is the definition of identifier and keyword? Identifier means when you are giving name to anything, like any variable or any class or any other thing, then it is called identifiers. So whenever you are going to naming any unknown things here, like you try to give a variable a new name, a class a new name, a method a new name, they are known as the identifiers. So for whenever we are going to naming the identifiers, then we should follow some rule that whenever we are fixing one name, that should consist of letters and digits. First character must be an alphabet or underscore. No other special characters are allowed or no digits are allowed in the first as the first character. Both upper and lower case cases are allowed. Some text of different case is not equivalent. For example, suppose you have defined the variable with capital letters text, it will not same as small letter text. মানে তুমি যদি ক্যাপিটাল লেটারে টেক্সট ডিক্লেয়ার করো থ্রু আউট দ্য প্রোগ্রাম, ইউ হ্যাভ টু মেনশন দ্য ক্যাপিটাল লেটার টেক্সট, ইউজ দ্য স্মল লেটার টেক্সট। সো আমাকে আমি এবার একটু জিজ্ঞাসা, এই চারটে লাইন সবাই একটু দেখো, দিজ আর দ্য নেমিং, দিজ আর দ্য ওয়ে টু ডিক্লেয়ারিং দ্য আইডেন্টিফায়ার্স। সো ইফ আই আস্ক ইউ, 1, 2, 3, ইট ইজ নট আ ভ্যালিড আইডেন্টিফায়ার নেম, দেন হোয়াট উইল বি ইয়োর রিজন?
The first character is required to be an alphabet.
Yes, or underscore. Okay. BCA student, বুঝতে পারছো কেন, why this 1, 2, 3 is not a valid character? These are valid one and these are invalid one. Tell me first that 1, 2, 3, why not valid identifier? Then tell me why not in double quotes x dot is not a valid identifier. Why?
It should start with an alphabet and it is a special character starting with.
Quotes are special characters. That's why it is not valid.
Yes, quotes is a special character which is not allowed. बोलो।
मैम मैम द प्रोग्राम विल स्टार्ट विद stdioh राइट
यस 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 ওই তো ওই জায়গাটা আসেনি এখনো। অর্ডার নাম্বার হচ্ছে অর্ডার নাম্বার হাইফেন অ্যালাউড হাইফেন নট অ্যালাউড অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিস ইজ আর নট সো হাইফেন অ্যান্ড স্পেস দিজ আর নট অ্যালাউড সো দিজ আর নট ভ্যালিড আইডেন্টিফায়ার্স। নাও দ্য থিং ইজ দ্যাট সাম ভ্যালিড আইডেন্টিফায়ার্স আর দিস ওয়াই বিকজ সি দিস ইজ স্টার্টেড উইথ ক্যারেক্টার দিস ইজ অলসো স্টার্টেড উইথ ক্যারেক্টার this is started with underscore this is the only combination of characters this is a combination of characters including a special character underscore so no invalid rules are followed here so these are all valid identifier names so valid identifiers should be ki hote hobe je made up of characters and digits but first letter only to be character or underscore no digit is permitted and no other special characters excluding underscore are prohibited okay ek second daro tell me what is the meaning of keyword what is the meaning of keyword
They are the words which cannot be used exclusively by users as they are system defined.
Yes. Yes. Acha like char, int these are data types while do if else type def auto case static break return return enum union these are all words these words which are given in this box they have a special meaning and that meaning is specified in the stdio.h file and whenever compiler is going to compile the program and on reading the program he get across through this type of words then they will automatically understood that the meaning of these words while we are using if why we are using else why we are using while so keyword are words having special meanings which have already known to the compiler so while reading the program if the compiler encounters these words that compiler will not generate any syntactical error what is syntactical error acha ek second ektu hold karo ha amake bolo je didar jonno google id ta dite je oi kagoje likhe diyechi chandra.5 বাবাকে ডাক আসছেন এক মিনিট এখানে এসো
নাম কিছু শুনতে পাচ্ছি না
Now you can hear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there are several data types: int, char, float, double. Type of data: integer, character, floating point number. Floating point number with higher precision. Each integer, if you declare one variable integer, it will take up 2 bytes in a memory. Allocate 2 bytes. For character, it is allocate 1 byte. For float, it allocates 4 bytes. And for double, it allocates for 8 bytes. 1 byte equals to how many bits?
8 bits.
8 bits.
8 bits. So 2 bytes means how many bits? 16. So 16. Each integer occupies 16 bits. So for representing one integer, you need 16 bits to cover it. Then character, it is 1 byte. 8 bits you require to represent it. Floating point number, 4 bytes. I mean 32 bits are required to cover one floating point number. And 8 bytes means 64 bits, where one character should have 8 bytes or 64 bits required to represent it.
Ma'am, your sound is not clear.
For everyone.
No, sir, check your internet connection because the voice madam is very clear.
I think.
It's very clear. Please check your internet connection
loose thakbe, tad low thakbe, tader sound to clear hobe na, ekhane amar kichu korar nei because everyone is muted, everyone's video is off. So there is, if there any problem, maybe in your internet connection. Now the integer itself divided in short int and long int. See, a short int size is 2 byte, long int size is 4 byte. So if there are two bytes in size, then the ranges it support is the numbers from -32,768 to 32,767. All the numbers falls below this, under this category, means -32,768. Then it dropped down like -32,767, 66, 65. This way it will come to zero and again go back to 32,767. So these total numbers are fall in the short category. And see, whenever they are occupying the size of 4, so more very if 2 bytes, then 16 bit occupancy, then the numbers range which is supported, this is this much. If 4 byte is the occupancy of one integer, when if you declare one integer, it takes up 4 bytes, then how many numbers are possible with that sort of data type? Now these are the range from this number to this number. Total that much of numbers can be supported by the data type long int. Now signed int and unsigned int. One thing I am telling you, for variable, it is signed int, because variable both have plus and minus values. But for unsigned int, for address, suppose whenever you are declaring on a variable, that means you are accommodating or sharing some area in the memory. And that is called the address. Suppose I am declaring int a equals to 5. That means you are allocating one integer variable. You know how many one integer contain 2 bytes, 16 bit location. So this integer, when you declare whenever you declare one integer, it will occupy some memory, and that is designated by some memory address. Whenever we are try to print or scan the memory address, then it will be unsigned int. Eta tumra ekhon bujhte parbe na signed and unsigned int er byapar ta. When other chapters will come like pointers, then we will understand. Similarly, signed card and unsigned card. Signed card, see, ektai jinish bujhte pabe je ei je 32,767 and -32,768, if we subtract this number from this, then the total number will be this. And if we subtract 127 -128, then the total number will be 255. So we have cut down the negative part in the unsigned integer because they are only positive. The variable's value can be negative, but variable's address cannot be negative. So for a variable declaration, we are using signed int, and for variable declaration we are using signed int, and for address declaration we are using unsigned int. Now variables are a temporary storage location inside the memory. See this program, how we are declaring variable. How many variables are declared? Any BCA student? BCA students, please tell me how many variables are declared in this line.
Ma'am, three variables.
Three variables, ma'am.
All of them are which data type?
Integer.
Integer. Okay, suppose you are declaring int A. How much size it is occupying in the memory? How much size?
6 bit.
1 byte.
6 bit. Why? 6 bit. Hello, kothe ke? Already I told.
Ma'am, 2 bit. 2 bit.
Not 2 bit. It's byte. There is a vast difference between byte and bit. 1 byte equals 8 bit. 2 byte equals to 16 bit. So it's not 6 bit. It is 16 bits. Understood? Uske baad aasha kori.
Okay. Okay.
These are some equations. So some tell me one thing. Int A and A equal to mute please. Int A B C. Please mute. Santosh, you please mute yourself. Okay, can you hear me all now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. So tell me one thing, which line is declaring the variables and which line is initializing the variables from this program? Short expressions, you tell me which line is declaring the variables and which lines are initializing the variables.
First line and second line.
First line and second line key.
Declaring the variables.
Very good. And the third line.
And third to sixth line are initializing the variables.
Yes, initializing the variable. And the fourth line is an expression. C equals to expression. A plus B. It is an expression. Declaring variables. See, they have declared variable. Many variables are declared. You can see. This way you can declare the variable. And in similarly, with the declaration of variables, we have to initialize that. Initialize means we have to give some value to this variable. Now we have covered up variables, keywords, and their data types. Now we are coming to constants. So whenever you are writing a C program, what the thing you require? Variable require, data types require, keywords require, now constants. What are constants? Suppose the value is the constant, variable is the, suppose you are declaring a variable int A, and when you give a value int A equals to 5, that 5 is a constant, and it is what type of constant? It is an integer constant. What are constants? Those values were not going to change. So those values we are not going to change, that is called a constant. So during constant declaration, rules for form integer and floating point constants. See, what are the rules? No comma or blank space is allowed in a constant. It can be preceded by minus sign if desired. The value should lie within a maximum and minimum permissible range decided by the word size of the computer. Now see the decimal integer constants. Some valid decimal integer constants 1443 32767. Now some invalid integer constants 1245. See why it is not allowed? Because comma is not allowed, point is not allowed, space is not allowed, my illegal character, this is not allowed, hyphen, and the first digit should not be zero. But these are all valid decimal integer constants. Achha. You have gone through MCS 12. MCS 12 ta ki tumra korecho? MCS 12.
Ma'am, kichu kichu ta korechi.
Okay, so can you tell me why these are invalid octal integer constants? All integer octal constants need to be started with zero. So if zero is not given in the first place, it is not a valid. But here zero is given, still it is not an valid octal constant. Why?
Those octal numbers will not have 8 in them. It will be only, yes, from 0 to 7.
Yes, octal numbers, see, decimal numbers from 0 to 9, binary numbers 0 and 1, and octal numbers 0 to 7, and hexadecimal number 0 to 9 and A to F. So all numbers which are combination of this ranges, they are only those type of constants. So octal only support from 0 to 7. 8, 9, these are not accepted. So this is not a valid octal constant. Dot, it is also not allowed, because for the naming of the constants, we are seeing these rules. If the value of constant does not obey any of its rule, then it will not be a constant. So tell me why these are valid hexadecimal integer constants and why they are invalid. Because these constants not only begin with zero, they will begin with 0x or this one, and are followed by combination of digits taken from hexadecimal digits only from 0 to 9 and A to F. So letters from A to F are allowed, and digits from 0 to 9 are allowed, and if hexadecimal number should be started with 0x or this OX. So you tell me why these are invalid hexadecimal integer constants. Why this OBFF is not a valid integer constant? Because every hexadecimal integer constant
X is not included, ma'am.
Yes, zero is there, or O, but X is not given here. But here X is given, still its dot is given, because A to F. So B is under A to F, F is also under FF. So 0x4BFF, these are all okay, but dot is an illegal character. And here G is an illegal characters, because we have asked for 0 to 9 and A to F. Now, so these are the, so you will ask, ma'am, where we will put this integer constants or floating constants in the value part. Like these are the constants. Show here. A equal to 3. A is what type? Integer type. And you have given one integer constant here. 3 is an integer constant. B is an integer variable. 5 is an integer constant. If they are float, then their values will be float. If they are car, their values will be car. So all the values are generally the constants. Okay. Achha. Some character constants, all the character constants, if they are a single character, they are quoted with single quotes. And if they are multiple characters, they are quoted with double quotes. If you give a value of single character, then these are all allowed. A, so the, suppose CAD, your variable name is VAD. char var equal to capital A. So the var is having the value of A. Char var equals to small x. The var will be equal to small x. And the null character is slash 0, whose value is 0. So character constants, integer values associated depending on the character set. Which character set is supported? Sometimes it is supported by ASCII character. Sometimes it is supported by Unicode character and so on. Generally, we will support the ASCII character set. That is a 7-bit character set. Escape sequence. What is escape sequence? Suppose you are writing a C program and you try to, in C program, double quotes and slash everything has. Give me one minute break.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello. Can some, am I audible to you? Yourself? You all? Am I audible to you all?
Please. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Achha, the screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the characters which we cannot print, they, that non-printable characters, that are preceded with backslash. Like suppose you try to create a line in your C program. So is it possible pressing enter you can create a new line? No, because you are writing a program and you are running the program. তুমি ব্যাংক থেকে আমাকে একবার ফোন করো because all you cannot type enter to print. You can type your name to print, you can type a variable, you can type a value, but you can type enter. So suppose suppose there will be multiple outputs with a single line gap, then you have to create one single line gap, and that single line gap which are you need to introduce in your program, they will be done by slash n. This slash n means it is new line character. If you want to create a tab in your program, you will undergo slash t. If you try to write this double quotes, try to print the double quotes, because double quotes is having another meaning in C program, then if you want to try to print the double quotes, then you will use the backslash character. So backslash character, where we will use when those characters, those keyboard characters which cannot be easily printed. There are some non-printable characters that can be printed by preceding them with slash backslash. Within character constants and string literals, you can write a variety of escape sequence. Suppose you are printing too many lines, so there you can use the string literal, sorry, backslash character. Suppose you try to create one backslash, then you will give here two backslash. Suppose you try to print question mark, you will give there slash question mark. Suppose you try to print single quote, then slash single quote. If you try to print double quotes, then slash double quotes. If you try to create a new line, then slash n. If you try to create a new tab, then you could create slash t. So jemon amra word ba other guy GUI, graphical user interface, we are just clicking the buttons, we are pressing the enter, a new line will be created, we are pressing a tab, a new tab will be created, we are pressing the double quotes, it will be printed. But in C program, as the in the program, those characters have already special meaning and they are not going to be printed non-printable characters. Then we, because I cannot ask my program to enter a line, enter a new line. I cannot cannot press during running the program to create a new line. So what we'll have to do, that if I try to create a new line before a particular statement, then we have to use the slash n character. During programming, you can see the example of those backslash characters. So these backslash characters are non-printable characters, and why they are backslash character, because they all preceded with a backslash, and backslash characters are used to print the non-printable characters. Already string, constant, I have told you about the constants, and I told if it is a character constant, it will be created quoted by a single quote, and if it is a string constants, then it will quoted by a double quotes. Now in home, you will practice the check your progresses. Now the expressions and operators. Suppose when we are going to write one C program, what the things we need? One variable we need, and as a part of the value of the variable, we can put a constant, a new variable, a new expression. Then variable equals to constant, b equals to 5. So it is one constant is assigned to a variable, b equals to a. Another variable is assigned to b, and b equals to a plus 5, what does it signifies for b equals to a plus 5? Eta ki signify korche?
Expression.
Okay, and how many types of expressions are there? Arithmetic, logical, relational, mixed. Suppose if you are giving plus minus into divide modulo these operators inside your operations, then these are arithmetic operators and your expression will be a arithmetic operation. In C, there is a difference of writing things from normal algebraic notation writing. In algebra, we will write this way, B into G by D. But in normal programming, this by sign is not allowed. We have to use this by sign and B into G by D. Now, we directly cannot put square or cube in normal programming language. So, AQ plus CD, it is not a valid expression in C. So, what will be the valid expression? For A cube, you have to find out A into A plus C into D. A into A plus C into D. Achha, arekta jinis janta hobe, whenever we are writing different operations, if I divide one integer by another integer, 5 by 3 is how much? Tell me. 5 by 3 is?
1.6.
Is it giving 1.6?
No. It is an integer value. Therefore, floating point.
As both of them are integer, only the integer part is being seen. That is deducted, but this is not acceptable. So we generally need to do, for if any result which may have fractional answer, we try to declare them with float. And if this new rule is, if there are two variables, the any one is integer and other one is float, then the result will be float. See, here 5 is float, 3 is integer, result is float. Here 5 is integer and 3 is float, that is result is float, and here both are float, then result is float. Tale the problem comes only that time when both of them are integers. So if I need fractional result, then we need some fractional variables also, that is float variables, because if I divide one integer by an integer, it only gives you the result of 1. Next. And the priority operators, see this, suppose in your equation, this sort of expression is given. So from your school's board mass rule, it will be followed that the order is bracket is the number one category, then multiplication, then division, then minus. So bracket is to be executed first. So here, as the bracket is in 3 plus 4, so 3 plus 4 equals to 7 will be executed first. After bracket, the priority is of multiplication operator. So 7 plus 5, 12 will be executed. Then 12 by 6, 3 will be executed. Multiplication, division, modulo operators are evaluated next. If an expression, suppose, or acta expression and moddhei, multiplication, division and modulo ache. So in which way they will write? They will scan the total system from left to right, and from into divide and modulo, who will come first from left to right, that will be executed first. So if an expression bracket is there, the bracket will be executed first. If an expression multiplication, division and modulo, they are all have equal priority. One low level priority is plus minus. If multiplication, division and modulo is having the same priority, you will ask, ma'am, then if in a single statement all of them are being used, then how they will be executed? So I will tell you, scan the system from left to right, and from multiplication, division, modulo, if these three are come, then who will come in the leftmost part, that will be executed first. And this way that will shift your cursor to the right. Tamane jegulor ekhi priority ache, sheguloke left to right associativity dekhte hoy. Thik ache? Left to right jeta age porbe, that we need to be executed. this is the priority of expression. And another thing, eta bolar age ami bolchi, another thing we should know that there are arithmetic operator, you all know. Now there are also relational operator, less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to, equal to, equal to, not equal to. But there are also some logical operator, logical and, logical or, logical not. Suppose this double n percent is representing the logical and. And logical and means, suppose this is a and, it is joining two statement, b plus c and b less than c. Suppose already you have given the values of b plus c, b and c, and also give the values of b less than c. So b plus c, eta to holoi na mane properly. Actually ami just jinish ta bole dicchi, the value of a variable if it contains logical operators will be true. Air value either true hobe or false hobe. Kokon true hobe? If both the conditions are true, only that time it will true. Otherwise, if any of the condition is false, then value of A is false. And if both of the conditions are false, then value of A is also false. So for logical AND, need to be true. A variable using logical AND, its answer need to be true if both the conditions are true. And for logical OR operator, which is not given here, that will be a double pipe from your keyboard. If any one of the condition is true, your answer is true. But if both of the condition is false, then your answer is false. Egulo konotai without program you cannot understand. But before programming, you need to be familiar with this sort of things, so that once the program will come, once the program will executed, or you have to write the program, or you have to read some other's program, you can find out the why they are writing like this. Suppose you are going to study some book of C programs, then you can understood. As I tell me, is this priority order okay?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Acha, why? Tell me. Because into divide modulo, only divide is there. And divide, here one divide. Who is the leftmost divide? This. So this is having the highest category. Then this divide, this is the second highest category. So 8 by 5 and 5 by 2. That you have to find out first. And then you minus and plus. So if you are using minus and plus, it will,
yeah,
we'll go from left to right.
Priority this din aapko
nahi chutti lena hoga,
hoga 10 din pehle
karega step se cutting ho sakta hai.
Ma'am plus er priority beshi na minus er theke?
Ha shetai beshi, kintu jokhon left to right ashe na plus কে একই ঘরে রাখা হয়, ঠিক আছে? মানে এরকম অর্ডারটা এরকম আসে, ফার্স্ট লেভেলে ব্র্যাকেট, সেকেন্ড লেভেলে ইনটু ডিভাইড মোড, আর থার্ড লেভেলে হচ্ছে তোমার ইনটু ডিভাইড মডিউলো, অ্যান্ড থার্ড লেভেল দেয়ার ইজ প্লাস মাইনাস. সাপোজ নাও প্লাস অ্যান্ড মাইনাস both are come in a single statement, then which one is, you have to find out the left to right association.
Of course.
Okay, otherwise plus is having the higher priority as compared to the minus. So you should go for the check your progresses. Now you have time of 2 hours or 3 hours, you can go for the check your progresses for the unit 3 and unit 4 of this block, because I am going to complete unit 1 and unit 2 in the afternoon class of the second block. Second block for MCA is also not covered, because I directly jumped to the third block. So today in the second half I will start from the second block, and I will give you some home assignments, some programs to write to write in your home, because in Monday we will also have two set of class. Monday now in in Sunday, I think Sunday or Saturday. Any one of this? You have also. We have also another class.
Saturday.
So one day you will have. I will give you some assignments here.
Ma'am, one question is there.
Is related to your official part.
Negative, ma'am. You are telling about assignments. How do we complete and submit them?
Second, when you are in class, why you are unmuting yourself? Throughout the class, you are unmuted and you are talking with someone else. Is this the way to join a class? And now you are asking about the assignments. Can you tell me what the things today I have covered in this class?
Yes, ma'am. You told about the variable.
One thing is that, yes, you are disturbing the class and I am asking you repeatedly that you please mute yourself. You are not listening to me. This is not the way to join a class. Others, students are getting disturbed. Me also getting disturbed. And what you are saying, assignments. See, writing of assignments is totally the work of students. You are copying the thing from book or internet. Then why are you asking teachers? It is the total responsibility of student. And if in any sort you are getting difficulty, that ma'am, from where we can get this, then only I can help. This is not the thing that teacher will do the assignments. The student have to do. Then tell me, what is your question?
Ma'am, my question was, when you're telling about assignments, where do we submit them?
I am not telling about assignments. And this is not my job to tell you where to submit the assignments. Why you are not connecting to the RC, regional center? You are in office, na? Then why you are not coming to Vikash Bhavan?
Okay, ma'am, I'm
ask
sorry.
Them. You go there, you ask about, and if you actually, the rule is now, what I know, that it is centrally accepted, not the, you don't submit this according to my, I am not authorized to tell this, where to submit assignments and where to this. I am only authorized to give your class. Once you disturb the whole class and now you are asking about assignments, then current rule is every assignment in hard copy you have to submit to regional center. And if you are not able, you find if the link is still active in the www.ignurckolkata.com. In this website you go, Kolkata website, regional website you go. If any assignment, follow the class niche. Why you are asking these things here? Disturbing class? And don't unmute yourself. One thing is there for every student. If you have to submit the assignment, you go to RC and give your hard copy. Otherwise, you can log on to the IGNU RC Kolkata website, where you will find the assignment link. If the link is active till now, then you can log on to that link, click on that link and upload your assignment if they are permitting to upload you. And if they are not permitting to upload you, please, you make your hard copy and go to regional center and submit your assignment there and give your all details there, that from which study center you are submitting. And another thing is there. One thing I have to ask this Santosh Kumar, which study center you are belongs to? Which study center?
Ma'am, Vikash Bhavan.
Vikash Bhavan. Then why you are not asking Tapan? Why you don't know Tapan? Tell me, you don't know?
Ma'am, I'm sorry. I was not having any idea about
it. Not ready. Dekho, tumi amake jiggesha korecho bole ami kintu tomar upor rag korchi na. Jiggesha kortei paro. Kintu tumi jokhon class ta cholchilo, tomake ami 1000 time ami bolchi je you mute koro, ekhane kotha bolo na. Tumi puro tomar official kotha barta ekhane system e aschilo. Is this allowed? It will be recorded in the system.
I'm sorry, actually what happened, ma'am? Ma'am, you asked one question, I was answering, and after that I forgot to mute.
But I am telling you, to mute yourself. You didn't hear my words. You should.
I'm sorry for that.
You are attending the class.
Yeah, I am sorry for that.
Okay, I think your assignment related query is cleared. One is if assignment link is still active, you can submit the assignment in link from the website itself. Otherwise, personally, you do the hard copy, put all the details, go to Bikash Babun and serve it to Tapan. He is there to help you. Okay.
ম্যাম এই নোট কি পেতে পারি আমরা?
হ্যাঁ, কোনটা বলো তো?
এটা দেখা স্ক্রিনে দেখা,
আরে এটা তোমাদের বই তো?
ও
আচ্ছা, 11 এর বুকস, এটা তোমাদের বুকস, ঠিক আছে? আমি তো বই দেখেই পড়াচ্ছি, তাতে কোনো প্রবলেম না হয়। আচ্ছা
ম্যাম, ক্যান ইউ গো অফ নাও?
ক্যান ইউ টেল মি এগেইন?
ম্যাম, দ্য নেক্সট ক্লাস উইল বি এট 3 ও'ক্লক, রাইট?
ইয়েস 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 ইয়েস।
So can we go off now?
Okay. So from here, I will start from the next class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Bye-bye.
Okay. Ma'am, একটা question ছিল।
হ্যাঁ বলো, তাড়াতাড়ি বলো।
হ্যাঁ, বলছি যে আমাদের তো ল্যাব ক্লাস হয়নি, তো আমি যদি কম্পিউটারে যে সি প্রোগ্রামিং করব, তো কোন কম্পাইলার ইউজ করা যেতে পারে ম্যাম?